All right, so welcome to our day three of our COVID hiatus, and just looking at an opportunity for us to grow during this time of being in quarantine and things being canceled at the church, and have an opportunity to grow in our faith as we get ready for school to start back. And so, you know, we had a great time at camp, and we don't want to miss out on what God did for us at camp and how He showed us who He is. And we want to be able to move on from camp into school, still strong in our faith and strong in our experience that we have with God. And so here's what we want to do. We did some giveaways while we were at camp. I have some more giveaways for after camp. So we got a big one today, a really big one. I got this really awesome North Face duffel bag. It's really nice. It says Fuge Camps right on the side of it. You're going to need this for next year when you sign up to go. So the first person to comment in our video, let me know what my favorite candy is. You'll have to guess. You'll have to figure it out. But my favorite candy, the first person to comment will get this here duffel bag. It's like $100 value. Super nice, super awesome. You're going to love it. So comment, what is my favorite candy? First one to figure it out. Wins the duffel bag. And so we're going to continue on looking at this 2 Timothy chapter 2 example that Paul was giving to Timothy of who we should be as followers of Christ. You know, yesterday we talked about how we're supposed to be soldiers, dedicated, training, giving everything we have to train up in God's word and to be who He wants us to be. To be the best that we can be, the best followers of Christ that we can be. And so today we're looking at the athletes. And so it's great that we're right here in this time of the Olympics, right? We get to see all these athletes from all across the world coming together to compete in Tokyo. And I don't know if you've been watching much, but there's been some crazy things going on. You know, there's these teams that are supposed to be undefeatable, right? And they're losing. There's people that have been lost since, you know, what, 2016, or haven't lost in so long, that are being defeated. And just shows like the competition that's out there. It's not just a given to win, no matter how great you are. There's always someone that's trying to take down that top spot, take down the number one person. You know, we've seen things with like dress codes and teams being fined for not dressing the way they're supposed to. We've seen things with COVID and people that have to drop out because they get COVID. We've seen the Russians showed up, who were supposed to be banned from these Olympics, are now figured out a way around the rules to be there for the Olympics this year. And so many crazy things. And not only that, but even the qualifying and preparing for the Olympics, we've seen some crazy things of just people trying to get into the Olympics and to make it happen. And so what we see is these athletes, they've been giving everything that they have for basically their whole entire life to get to this moment where they're able to compete in the Olympics on the world stage for everyone to see. And so this is like the best of the best that there are in the world coming together that have just given everything they have. That same dedication that we saw in the soldiers is being displayed through the Olympics, these Olympics that we've been watching so far. So emotions are high, and people are just giving everything they have to be the top person, to win that gold medal or the silver or the bronze, or even just to show up and be on TV and to say they went to the Olympics, right? People are giving everything they have to make that happen. However, some of the most disappointing things that we see is when people get to this point where they're in the Olympics and they're giving everything they have, that we eventually find out that they've been doing something that they shouldn't do according to the rules, that they get to a place where they've been cheating. They've been doing something that is against the rules or against the laws of the Olympics. And so when that happens, it's so disappointing that someone's trained their whole entire life to get to this point, and then when it comes down to it, they break the rules or they do something that is against the rules that causes them to be disqualified. And so when we look at Timothy's example, Yesterday it was verses 1 through 4 we looked at. Today in verse 5 of chapter 2 in 2 Timothy, Timothy says this, an athlete is not crowned unless he competes according to the rules. Now when we apply that to our faith, it's important for us to be able to compete in our faith or in life according to the rules that God has given to us. Rules matter. Rules are important. When we see these Russians that have shown up, somehow they worked around the system and made it so that their people that are from Russia can still compete in the Olympics, but technically Russia has been banned because of allowing their people to take substances that are illegal, that are performance-enhancing substances. People have been caught cheating all throughout the history of the Olympics, and what happens is once they find out, they are disqualified from being able to earn any medals or anything that they did. Everything that they accomplished is now worthless. It means nothing because they bent the rules or broke the rules or tried to give themselves an advantage that no one else has. And so this is sad when we see this happen, right? But Paul, he uses this example of the athletes to really show us that rules have a purpose. Rules matter. When it comes to the Olympics, it's to make sure that everyone is on the same level. They have the same playing field that they're in, and no one has an advantage over anyone else. And so they all are competing on the same level, and it's really up to the person to determine how great they are, not the giving themselves an advantage above anyone else. And it really kind of goes the same way when it comes to life, right? And the things that we do. God has given us parameters in the world. He's given us laws and rules to really put us all on the same playing field, but also to show us that there is a right and there is a wrong way to live. There are right things that we should do and there are wrong things that we should not do. And so thankfully, when we do the things that are wrong, which is called sin, that Jesus gave his life for us on the cross. And so we know what God has done for us because of our sin, but now because we believe, because God is in our lives, and he's become our Lord and our Savior, that Jesus Christ is our Lord and Savior, that it really changes our outlook on what it is to do right or to do wrong. And so Paul is encouraging Timothy and the church that he's setting up that it's really important for us to follow the laws that God has set up for us, especially if Jesus is our Savior, if God has changed us and made us a new creation, that he's forgiven us of our sin. Now we should operate within those laws, showing that one, we're obedient, we trust God, but two, that we follow the standard that God has given us because it's important. These standards are good things, right? They're not just to make life miserable, but actually when we follow the laws, it makes life enjoyable. It gives us freedom, actually, and it gives us the opportunity to be a great example to other people. Laws are a good thing because it allows us to operate in a way that we love other people and we treat other people well and we do good and right things. Now, when we get to another passage that Paul wrote, in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, in verse 24, he starts talking about athletes, and he talks about this idea of athletes breaking the rules or doing things that are not right. He says this, "Do you not know that in a race all the runners run, but only one receives a prize? So run that you may obtain it. Every athlete exercises self-control in all things. They do it to receive a perishable wreath, but we an imperishable. So I do not run aimlessly. I do not box as one beating the air, but I do discipline my body and keep it under control, lest after preaching to others, I myself should be disqualified." And so he gives us this idea of there's athletes that are out there and they're all working towards this goal, right? To win the prize. And when it comes to the Olympics, when it comes to these competitions, there's only one person that's really going to be the winner. And then we award second place and third place as well. But there's only one real winner. And so it takes dedication. It takes self-control. It takes discipline to get to that point where you're that person. But then you throw in this idea of people who who kind of go against that, that they maybe try to give themselves a certain advantage, or they break the rules, or they just lose focus completely. It's like a runner who is running aimlessly. Instead of running the track like everyone else, they may just be running the middle of the field and running all over the stands, or just running wherever they want to. They may run the same distance, they may run in the same building, but they're not running the path that has been set out for them, right? And that's confusing. It makes no sense. It's really worthless because they're never going to cross the finish line in the way that they're supposed to. Or a boxer who is just wildly punching at the air, right? They're not competing in any way. They may be going through the same motions, going through the same things as a boxer would do, but they're not really competing in the manner that they're supposed to when it comes to a competition. Sometimes we do that with our own faith, right? We can easily do that with our own faith. When we kind of put aside the idea of I'm saved by Jesus Christ, and now with a repentant heart, I want to do what is right, then that's operating in the manner that we're supposed to. It's running the track in the way you're supposed to. It's boxing against a person in the way that you're supposed to. But when we start to live a life where we don't follow God's laws as a saved person, and we have an unrepentant heart, and we're not trying to be obedient to God's laws, then it's really a waste of time. That we try to look the part, we try to fit in, we're really not operating in the manner that God has designed for us as followers of Christ. It's just a huge waste of time. It doesn't help us in any way. It doesn't point to Christ in any way. And those who are lost have a horrible example. And so it's important for us to see God's laws, and that we discipline ourselves in a way that we follow His laws. That is important. And I think that's something that we should take home today. How can I discipline myself in a way that I follow God's law to show obedience? Showing obedience to God's word shows love to Him as well. Let's pray together. God, we love you. We thank you for loving us. And we just thank you for your word and how you constantly point us in the right direction. God, I just pray today that as we consider this idea of the athlete, that God, we want to operate in a manner, that we want to compete in our life in a manner, not that we're better than anyone else, but God, that we're fulfilling what you have put before us, that we're competing in a way that shows that we follow after you and we trust you. And so God, help us to know what's right and wrong, and help us to live that out. And God, we just pray that the Holy Spirit would be working in our hearts to help us to do that and to push us in the right direction. And God, help us to be a great example to others and to show obedience to you, because we love you, God. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. See ya.